Hi, I'm Dave with AirSpool, and people, they ask me, Dave, how many solar panels does it take to run an air conditioner anyway? Well, the answer, if it's an AirSpool unit, is 3. Oh, and if you need even more details, continue watching this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is appropriately enough called AirSpool. So what are the challenges of running a normal air conditioner off of solar? Well, solar is inherently direct current. Normal air conditioner runs off of alternating current. So you need to transform that DC solar power to alternating current to run the unit. Not a big deal. You lose maybe 3 to 5% of your solar power in the process. A bigger deal is a unit like this one here. It has two speeds, on and off. And every time it turns on, there's a huge surge or inrush current. It's 4 to 6 times the normal current. So you hear, you feel it, and it takes either 4 to 6 times more solar panels, or you're gonna need a battery bank of around 530 amp hour, 12 volt batteries to accommodate each ton of air conditioning to work through this few seconds when the unit is starting up. The biggest problem of all is, what do you do at nighttime or when it's cloudy? Well, for that, you need a whole lot of batteries. You need up to 32 12 volt, 130 amp hour lead acid batteries, or you could have, try the new Tesla Powerwall, for instance. Challenge with that, $7,500, and that will only keep you going around 12 hours. And figure solar is running 8 hours during the day. You need probably 1.5 of those Tesla Powerwalls. So what are we doing instead? What are we embracing instead? We're exploiting the grid. We're embracing the grid. At nighttime and when it's cloudy and rainy, we're plugging in. Okay, here I lied a little bit. This is actually running, our unit here is running off of 4 solar panels. These are 380 watt Hanwha Q cells. They're last year's model. This year we'd be running off of 3 480 watt Hanwha Q cells. The unit needs around, absolute peak period of the summer, needs around 1200 watts to run. Okay, so this gives a little bit of cushion. Like you can see right now, it's a little bit cloudy, but we're still able to run, no problem. Okay, so here's the condenser for this unit. The price of these units, by the way, is $1,950. And the panels are around $1,500. Okay, so this, it's not super hot out, but you see the air, we're a few inches away here, but it's 101 degree air coming off of here. And this is running off of all solar, folks. See those two, the red and black plugs there? Those are solar connector, MC4 connectors connected into the unit. So it's DC power plugging directly into the unit to run the unit. Okay. And looky here. This is the plug. Okay, so it's totally unplugged and still running. In a moment, I'll show you the inside. Okay, here's the inside unit. This unit runs grid power off of at 22 SEER, but right now, again, it's running off of 100% solar. Okay, we have it set to 70 degrees, and it's 624, it's turning, my camera's turning, 624 watts of solar coming in right now. And you see the coil is at around 33 degrees, 32 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so that's all off of solar. So oops, sorry for the delay. If and when you need more details, email dave@airspool.com and check out airspool.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel, AirSpool. Thank you.